Hey guys, Mike King here, and today I'm going to train you on market segmentation and how to really separate yourself from every other agent out there in your market. Now, one of the biggest myths in the real estate market and most markets to be exact is that your messaging has to appeal to every single person in your marketplace or you run the risk of losing a potential client. So I want to give you a different perspective to consider because I understand why most agents and brokers would believe that. We see the majority of our peers doing this, so we internalize that we need to do this as well. It's easy to get caught up in this kind of groupthink, and the great Dan Kennedy calls this marketing incest. Everybody in a marketplace copies what everyone else is doing for fear of missing out, and as a result, they blend in with everyone else. So, in the eyes of the consumer, you're really positioning yourself as a commodity because your messaging cannot be specific enough to speak to them in a different and unique way. Allow me to show you a smarter and more effective way of going about this. Remember, it's your job to create ROI, relevancy, omnipresence, and intimacy. So let me flip over to my slideshow and let's jump in.
Okay, so let me show you what I see when I'm talking to a majority of my prospects and clients. And when it comes to typical market segmentation, they're typically putting people inside of one or two groups. Either first, all home buyers, or second, all home sellers. And that's as deep as they go in terms of segmentation. Well, I'd like to have you consider that you're actually diluting your message and not making it as effective as it could be by staying at this top level. And when you go beneath the surface and you actually peel back a couple of layers, not only can you make your messaging more specific, but this is one of the other ways that you can really have a distinction and separate yourself from all the noise that companies like Zillow makes when you can really go much deeper and speak to your prospect on a much deeper level. So let me show you what I mean here. And we want to get super specific because when we're specific, it increases the intimacy and the relevancy that we have in the marketplace. And we need to be leveraging these things as much as possible. So a quick example, we can take the segment of all home buyers, and I want you to think about how you could further break this up. So one example would be we could break this up by profession. But don't stop there. You want to drill down even further, right? So you could have messaging directed specifically towards people who are in education. You could have messaging that speaks directly towards people who are in healthcare. You can have messaging that speaks directly to veterans. You could have messaging that speaks directly to first responders. You can have messaging that speaks directly to people's hobbies. Maybe they enjoy riding horses and you're selling a property that's perfect for a person who's passionate about riding horses and you want to paint that picture to them. Maybe you want to speak to people who are passionate about fishing because you've got a great home for sale, or you know of a property that's listed on a lake, right? And you want to attract potential prospects who are interested in that lifestyle or interested in getting to enjoy that hobby more. Maybe they are into car racing and there's a property that's located in an area that could be used as a second home and give them more access to that hobby, right? So that's why it's important to really drill down. You know, another example could be golf. Maybe they're a huge golfer and there's a property located, or you compile a list of properties that are located near golf courses. So you wanna appeal to those type of things in your messaging. And this is how you really get relevant with your marketplace. Maybe they are pet owners and, you know, your messaging focuses on that and the great locations of homes that are near pet-friendly places, whether that's close to veterinarian offices or close to dog parks. There's all kinds of options. Another one would be sports teams. You know, maybe they're a huge, I don't know, NFL fan and they go to every single NFL game, but they're tired of renting hotels when they come to town, so they'd rather much just buy a small condo for them and their family that they can use when they're in town and that they can leave stuff there, right? So that they're more comfortable, or maybe they just want to use it when they're in town for the games and rent it out during the rest of the year. So these are all different angles that you can use to dissect this segment of the marketplace even further and create that messaging that brings congruency between you and the offer that you have for these people. It's all about speaking on your prospect's level, and everybody stops at the top level, which is classifying them as just home buyers or home sellers, when there's more to that, right? We're all unique human beings made up of different likes and dislikes, and when we can dive deeper and speak to those commonalities, we can have a far greater effect. So I want to show you a couple examples here of what's possible when you really do that. Okay, so here's an example I want to show you of the power of being more specific in your market segmentation. So this was an ad that we were running in California for a client, and you see it's being run from a community page, but it's super short and to the point, but very specific in its market segmentation. It says, attention California healthcare providers, take advantage of the healthcare new homeowners program in your area. Click here to learn more. Take them to a landing page, but it was to generate leads for people who are interested in buying a property that happened to be in the healthcare niche, because they tend to have solid jobs, they tend to have a decent income. So we ran this, and the results were tremendous. We got a ton of engagement on this ad, a ton of comments, as well as a ton of shares. And that's the power that you can have when you create messaging that speaks directly to a certain segment of the marketplace. So why cast such a wide net when you can cast a more narrow net and get more relevant with the audience that you're speaking to? So here's another example for a client out in California. This one was a mortgage ad, but it's still the same process, right? This one we're speaking to California teachers, educators, and staff. And then it's telling them to find out about some assistance options that they have available in their marketplace. We're showing them a home because that's what people are interested in, that are trying to buy and sell. And then this same type of ad as well, right? Tons of reactions, tons of comments, and then 86 shares. So that's really how you get great engagement on your messaging and really really expand your message in your marketplace by speaking to a specific group of people inside your market. So I really want to encourage you, as you're moving forward in your marketing, to really think about that and the people that are in your marketplace and how you can best chop that up and put those people into different buckets accordingly to what they do or what they like, and then build your messaging around that so that it's more personable, so it's more relevant to them and where they're currently at. And that's the power of marketing, and that's the power of messaging.